Okay, let's try this again. All right, LP2000, you know who this is. Yesterday I uploaded a video and to test out my new camera on a new iPhone I got over the weekend, and the footage looks great, but unfortunately you couldn't hear me, so I'm gonna be redoing this video of a virtual tour of my wife's and I figure collection. Also just had per request of Ron McKay. So this is for you. So let's get into the entire collection that I have, as well as my wife's, in this household right now. And as you can see, I'm giving you a first person view of what I see on an everyday basis, which is not half bad. It's actually great. So I'm gonna start from down here, then go upstairs to the Monster Island Man Cave. So let's get into it. I ain't watching wrestling. I better do this. This is more important and more interesting, as a matter of fact. But here, let's see. Start off with this one. It's kind of dark, but I think it's better in this light. It's a custom-made Godzilla 1991 from Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, one of my favorite incarnations of Godzilla. Throughout this video, you're going to hear three names. You're going to hear Mark Sang Yang, Burley Vang, and S Plus, which mostly comprise of my collection. So you're going to hear those three names a lot as this video goes along. So Mark Sang Yang made this for me, and he did a wonderful, absolutely phenomenal job. I can't wait to compare the upcoming Godzilla 1991 Yuji Sakai piece from S Plus. It's coming out hopefully the next 3 or 4 weeks. So soon this big guy, because he's 18 inches tall, will have a little brother soon. So, but yeah, this is what you start off looking at coming into the house. Then you move up here, and the two big monsters from one of my favorite movies of King Kong. Actually, it is my favorite movie of King Kong. King Kong Escapes, and you have a Billiken kid of a Mechanic Kong. S Plus, please get on the ball and make this figure, please. We really do appreciate it. Burley Vang made this for me. He customized it and painted it and made it for me and everything. I did the ghetto ingenuity by adding the batteries to simulate the grenade belt. Obviously, it doesn't look quite right, but hey, I'm no expert when it comes to this, but I think it looks all right. Not accurate, but hey, at least he's got something around his belt. But right here, the big guy right here, this is another custom-made King Kong Escapes, or King Kong 67 statue from Mark Sang Yang. He did a wonderful job, as you can see, on the face, on the whole body. Like I said, I really enjoy that movie of King Kong. My favorite movie of King Kong, him fighting Gorosaurus and Mechanic Kong, which is a great, 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 great movie. And like I said, I just love this Kong, and I love this statue. He really did a good job with this, from the detail and from the color and everything. I especially like the face. Although it maybe have a little goofiness to it, but still, my favorite version of King Kong ever. So, now let's move over here. And these actually are my wife's figures, the gigantic series. I like how the light is shown from the bottom here to illuminate from the bottom here. But this is my wife's gigantic Burning Godzilla, as well as her personal favorite, gigantic GMK. Yeah, she has a thing for serial killers. And right here in the middle is our King Ghidorah from X Plus, the 25 centimeter. So, such an awesome figure. Right here, the Three Kings. Yes, but and this is my wife's collection right here. As well as the Biollante here and Godzilla 1989. Now, the Godzilla 1989 is mine, but the Biollante, we're sharing that. So, it's more so hers than it is mine. But yes, this is a great setup right here. Have the Tyler monsters from Godzilla vs. Biollante here. Very, very great. Very great. Very awesome. And she does a lot of computer work, or she does a lot of leisure stuff on the computer. So I like to have those figures here within, like, view, so she can look at them every single time, you know, because she's a fan just like I am. So just want to have those within arm's reach. So here's a better look at the light right here. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So let's move over here. And the bottom half It's mostly my wife's figures. They're all my wife's figures, as a matter of fact. And there's the Blu-rays on the bottom. But here is Godzilla 1968 from Diamond, 30 centimeter. Hedra, 30 centimeter from Diamond. One of my personal favorites, Godzilla 1964. The original Japanese release of Godzilla 1999 or Godzilla 2000. Once again, one of my wife's favorites, the 30 centimeter GMK. Once again, she loves serial killers. And of course, the classic, the original Godzilla 1954 from Diamond. Awesome, awesome figure. Pick this up if you haven't got one yet, please pick this up. But yes, these are all my wife's figures. Right here on both rows, the top row and the bottom row. But this guy right here belongs to me. Yes, the Godzilla 1964 M1 built-up rubber kit. My holy grail, in case y'all haven't figured it out. But if you're new to the channel, first of all, welcome, and I'm glad to have you. Second of all, if you're not new to the channel, then you already know this is my favorite Godzilla of all time, as well as my favorite Godzilla figure. And it's my holy grail. So in other words, if a fire break out of my house, this one's coming out first. Just the detail, the fact that it is so lifelike with the rubber and everything. Like I said, it looks like just like a movie prop. From the dorsal plates to the way the curvature of his tail is all, it's all nice and everything. And it's just, like I said, it's a massive figure. It's 20 inches tall. And it's just, no matter what angle you look at it from, it's just an awesome, awesome, intimidating figure. So that's pretty much it for the downstairs. I mean, you know, it's great to look at this figure as well as these, the gigantic series and Biollante, and you got Kong over there. And so it's nice to have all these great pieces of Godzilla history, but that's just a small sample of what's in this household. Ain't it right, babe? So let's just go upstairs to the Monster Island Man Cave where I do my reviews and where most of the collection is displayed. So, man, I love this figure. But as I go up the stairs, I just want to just say that, you know, that each piece of my collection is, it's like I don't get everything. I'm not a completionist by any means. I mean, there are some monsters that I can live without, like Rodan 1993 or Gerber 1994. You know, so I'm not a completionist. Everything I have in my collection has a purpose and has a place. So so you might see more than one figure here, but that's just how I roll. But I get to that in a second. So let's start off right here. Oh man, these are awesome. The X Plus Gigan Rick board that just came out. The Godzilla 1968 from Diamond. Man, these two look great together. I know that it's been said that Godzilla is taller, or the Gigan is a little bit shorter than what it should be. But seeing these two together, you know, you can still say the Gigan is a little bit taller with that horn on top of his head. But still, maybe his face should be a little bit higher. But even still, these two together are absolutely awesome. So there's no imperfections here. The two big beasts that battled out in their 1972 epic film. And let's go over here to another Godzilla 1968. You probably wonder why I got more than one figure. Well, and this is a Marmot Kit Angulus. Well, because when Diamond reissued the Godzilla 68, this figure in particular has been long elusive. And it was very, very hard to find and hard to locate. And if you did find one, then you have to spend a pretty penny. So the fact that these came out a whole lot cheaper, I had to get two. Basically, getting two for the price of one, how they used to go for, was a no-brainer for me. So that's why I ended up getting two, because I love the Godzilla design, and it was just, you know, for a cheap price, and it was just awesome to get. So, and this is a Marmot Kit Angulus, like I said, 1972. I touched up the eyes a little bit, trying to give him the 1968 Angulus. Based off the 25 centimeter X Plus figure that just got reissued. So I did the pupils and the eyes with more yellowish, kind of like that figure does, just to give a more menacing look. But I would love the X Plus version, but Diamond's going to be reissuing him I mean, besides the 25 centimeter just came out, but the 30 centimeter is coming out through Diamond sometime in the next year. So that figure will be added along with the rest of them. But I love Angulus. You gotta love Angulus. Very underrated, underappreciated kaiju in my opinion. So, and let's move on to here. This is my 30 centimeter, not gigantic, but GMK 30 centimeter figure from X Plus, courtesy of Diamond. And what I did here, as you notice, I colored the tongue because this figure was great and everything, but they kind of did an oversaturation on the color of the gums, where all this was just was the same color. This color was the color of the tongue, so it really didn't look right. You probably couldn't tell on my wife's figure downstairs because it wasn't that illuminated. But now you can see. So all I did was just take a little pink paint and maybe mix a little bit of red in there, and just painted the tongue to offset the oversaturation of the color of the gums. And I think it looks great. You know, I'm a big fan of the gigantic GMK, but I would have to say, as far as this figure, they got the face perfectly. Nothing against the gigantic GMK or the 25 centimeter, but it's something about the 30 centimeter face that looks even more intimidating than those two. But that's just my opinion. So if you got the GMK 30 centimeter and you're not happy from Diamond, and if you're not happy with how the mouth looks, just apply a little pink onto the tongue and it'll look a whole lot better. So, but I love that figure. So, and let's move on over here to a custom-made statue by, you guessed it, Mark San Yang of the Godzilla 1974. Once again, one of my favorite incarnations of Godzilla. I'm hoping X Plus will make one down the line, or maybe I can get my hands on an MM28 Godzilla 74. Only time will tell. But in the meantime, this is a good statue. 16-17 inches tall, so I think he did a good job. I think he did. So, wonderful statue here of Godzilla 1974. Then you have the X Plus Diamond Ray issue of the Godzilla Raise Again crew, Godzilla 55 and Anguirus. Once again, an underrated movie and underrated kaijus, just because their appearances are not loved like the other incarnations, like the 68 of Godzilla and Anguirus. But still, without this movie, you know, we probably wouldn't have gotten all the other monster versus monster battles over the years. So every monster versus monster movie owes a debt of gratitude to this movie. If this wasn't a success, we probably wouldn't have got King Kong versus Godzilla, or Mothra versus Godzilla, or Godzilla versus Gigan. You get my meaning. So now let's go up here to the Gargantua brothers. Yes, from Diamond. And don't worry about Gyra's ketchup boobs. but yes, I'm glad I got these figures. Because War of the Gargantuas is my favorite film that doesn't have Godzilla in it. Such an awesome movie. Good versus evil. The fact that they're brothers, or in Japanese version, I believe Gyra is a clone of Sandra, but still, just an awesome movie, great movie, and of course I had to have it in my collection. And right up here, the 30 centimeter, or not so 30 centimeter, Space Godzilla. My daughter Olivia loves this figure, so. And I like it too, I really do. Like I said, it creates some diversity on my shelf. Even though he's not in my most favorite Godzilla film, but he still is an awesome kaiju to have on your shelf. And here's the SH Monster Arts by Alante. The reason why I got that, because I didn't think I was going to be able to get my hands on the X Plus version. But now that I do, I decided to keep both of them, you know. So there's a by Alante downstairs and a by Alante here upstairs. Just because this one doesn't really compare with the X Plus one for its size and detail, it's still a wonderful figure to have. SH Monster Arts is really, really good with details, even though it's on a smaller scale. But really, really awesome figure. And the Tokyo Mirai Godzilla 1989. Yes, love this radio control figure. It roars, it walks, it wags its tail, it moves its head or whatever. Very, very lifelike. What you gotta do is just basically, it has a plastic endoskeleton, and you put the Godzilla rubber suit over it for it to work. And this is probably one of my earliest figures I've ever gotten when I first started collecting. I got it way back in 2001. And 14 years later, it still works. You know, it still roars and still walks. But check out my review for that. in the archives of my channel, and you'll see what it can do. But really, really awesome figure. Now, I know Aaron Heeman is going to love this because he's a Gamera fan, just like David Dostas and Vince Elliott. Gamera 1996, 30 centimeter from X Plus. Gamera 1996, 25 centimeter from X Plus. Cool Kaiju from one of my favorite Godzilla films, Godzilla from Mechagodzilla. You got King Caesar, 25 centimeter X Plus version. Gamera 1967, 30 centimeter from X Plus. Yeah, X Plus is a whole, is represented really well up here. Gauss 1967 from X Plus, 25 centimeter. Gamera 1999 and Gamera 1995, both 30 centimeter from X Plus. Eric Henry, I know you're liking this. Two versions of Godzilla's right hand wingman, and pun intended, Rodan, the 30 centimeter, which is coming out from Diamond sometime this year or next year. The 30 centimeter and the 25 centimeter. I can't pick one over the other one. I love them both, which is why I had to get them both. Awesome, awesome, awesome figures. So my advice, get both. Don't pick one because one looks really, really good with the other one. So just the same monster, but with different perspectives because of the face and the beak being open, whereas this one doesn't have the beak open. But still, very, very awesome representation of Rodan. My favorite incarnation of Rodan, actually, the 1964 version. As well as you got the Godzilla 1989, another one. This is the original Japanese release. The other one downstairs with the Biollante was a Diamond Rare issue, but you couldn't really tell between the two because they both look awesome. And by that time, Diamond really stepped the game up and had their figures look exactly, or almost exactly like the Japanese original releases. So kudos to them. And here we go, once again, Double Vision. One of my also favorite incarnations of Godzilla, 1962, King Goji, as well as the two Martha Larvas. You got Larvae, whatever. Godzilla 1962 X Plus, Rick Boyle version that lights up, and the reissue. Like I said, I love Godzilla 1962. One of my favorite films, King Kong vs. Godzilla, just like I'm sure like everybody else's to a certain extent. And just a very, very iconic portrayal of Godzilla with the bulkiness of the suit, the size, the dorsal plate arrangement, the face, everything about this figure is perfect. Love this figure. And of course I got the two Martha Larvae from Diamond reissue. So I had to get two to recreate my scene, or one of my favorite scenes in my favorite movie, Martha vs. Godzilla. So I had to get two. Mind you, it's not the same Larva from that movie, but it's a good stand-in to accomplish that. So now down here, I got two versions of Baragon. I got the crawling version. It's a way built-up kit. You have the Yuji Sakai Godzilla in the back. Wonderful, wonderful figure. Beautiful figure. Very accurate representation of the Godzilla 1989. And, of course, I got a Billiken standing Baragon made by my brother, Burley Vang. I really do love this Baragon. I mean, I enjoy having this underrated monster. And each time I have this, I really don't regret not getting the X-Plus version because Burley did such a wonderful job. X-Plus, if you're watching this, you should hire Burley Vang immediately. That way I can get big free figures. I'm just joking. But yeah, I love this figure. Burley did an absolutely wonderful job with this figure, with the paint job and the face or whatever. And go to his website, AtomicMisfits.com. He has a kit of a King Kong 1967, and he has an upcoming kit of a Gabra soon to be released sometime in the summer. So let's support our boy so we can get these underrepresented kaijus in our collection. But yeah, I love that Baragon. He really did a good job with that. Now, you got Kumonga X Plus version, 25 centimeter. One of my daughter Olivia's other favorites, the 30 centimeter Varan. I don't know why she loves this figure, but she does. I may get her one soon, but she, for some reason, she loves this figure so much. I don't know. But and here's my Godzilla 1954 Diamond reissue. You got the 30 centimeter Diamond reissue of Gorosaurus. Didn't think I was going to get my hands on this figure. Like the Godzilla 68. Very, very hard to find before Diamond decided to reissue this figure. Highly expensive, but thanks to Diamond, that's created me an opportunity to get this figure. I don't see him out there that much. He's out there just a little bit, but he's not at where he was when he first came out around December of last year. So hopefully you can try and find one and get your hands on one for a good price without having to sell a kidney for it. 25-centimeter Zegra, a very underrated figure in my opinion, even though he was not in the most beloved Gamera film, Gamera vs. Zegra. But hey, I love the figure. I like the film, so yeah. So this is a built-up Ebera kit from Falchion, I believe, and it was given to me by another fellow collector. I don't want to say his name. He may not want me, he not may not want me to say his name, but you know who you are, man. I love you, bro, out there in Arizona. So you know who you are, and I put a rock underneath it to give him more size. It's standing next to his Godzilla vs. Sea Monster Kosar Godzilla. This is a built-up kit by, once again, Burly Vang. He took a 65 Billiken Godzilla kit and he painted like the Godzilla 66. So he looks great next to the Emperor. Wow, just seeing this figure made me want to watch the movie now. But all right, now here's my gigantic GMK from X Plus. Here's another Godzilla 1991 statue from Mark San Yang. Yes, I love Godzilla 1991. I do. Can't wait for the Sakai. I think I already said that, but hey, I'm gonna say it again. Now, another Mark San Yang piece, a Godzilla 1972, 15, 16 inches tall. Wonderful. I really do like Godzilla 1972. It's probably my favorite incarnation of that suit, the Godzilla 68 suit. It's just something about the 72 that I like so much. So I had to make it, so I had to have a statue made for that. So. And of course, Jim Jenkins, I know if you're out there watching, I know you'll find this guy very familiar. This is a 22 inches tall Paradise Godzilla 1962 kit, the King Goji. Now, he may not look how he is in the film. I kind of painted him, gave him a darker scheme, but I like it. You know, like I said, I'm not an artist by any means, but I do a little dabble here and there, and I gave him a little darker scheme, whatever, just to try to change things up a bit since I got an accurate version with the X Plus one. But still, this is an awesome representation of the King Goji. Now, I did the mouth as well as the eyes a little bit, so I think it came out really well. Another kit, courtesy of Burly Vang, Mechagodzilla 1993. I think it's a Sakuta built-up kit. X Plus USA King Ghidorah resin kit or resin figure. Love this figure. 1992 Billiken kit. Godzilla 1992 Billiken kit, sorry. Love this figure too. And he looks great next to the Mechagodzilla 1993. Mothra 1961, 25-centimeter standard version in the back. Here's my Godzilla 1964 Diamond reissue, as well as the Mothra, excuse me, the S Plus USA Mothra 1964. Can't wait to see how the upcoming Mothra 64 from S Plus Japan is going to stack up with this one, with the egg being there or whatever. And yes, I dabble in the Pacific Rim market because, you know, let's think about it. Pacific Godzilla inspired the Pacific Rim films. So that's why I got Gypsy Danger and Chernobyl Alpha, both 18-inch figures from NECA. And they go great with the Gigantic series. So that's why I got them. Can't wait for the Strike of Eureka, supposed to be coming out this month from NECA. I know everybody out there is a Godzilla fan or whatever. Don't sell NECA short when it comes to these Pacific Rim film, figures. They, like I said, they would go great with the Gigantic series. Absolutely awesome. Speaking of Gigantic series, here is, of course, is a repainted Godzilla 1995 Gigantic series Burning Godzilla figure that I repainted as the Rebirth version. And right next to it is the original Gigantic series Burning Godzilla. Love seeing these two together. Here is a built-up kit of Godzilla 1954 from Paradise. Love this figure. Without this figure, there wouldn't have been the Godzilla series. So much is owed to this design and to this movie. Wow. Now, here is Godzilla 1967 to go with the 30-centimeter Minya from Diamond. I love this figure. I love this Godzilla design. Yes, he's not the most intimidating one, but he was not supposed to be. I mean, in the film Son of Godzilla, he was not supposed to be what he was in Monster vs. Godzilla, or the original Godzilla 54, or Godzilla 84, or GMK. He was supposed to be a lovable father figure. And I love how the suit looks. Once again, this is a Mark Saint Yang custom statue. And I just really do love this suit. I really do love this statue. And he really do got the face down. You know, probably one of the most accurate representations of the face ever. So I really do love this kit. Excuse me, the statue. And next to his son, you know, awesome. Very, very awesome. So, you got Final Wars guy again from S Plus. I got this recently, the Wonder Fest Godzilla 2004 Rick Boy from S Plus. He has a wave kit from Burly Vang. Wave guy again kit. He painted the nighttime scheme like I requested, like the Wonder Fest guy again. They had a nighttime scheme that came out a few years ago. Really cool. And on this shelf, you got the title cast, the monster cast from the Terra Mechagodzilla, 30cm S Plus Titanosaurus, Abilican kit Godzilla 1975. And here is actually a Godzilla 1974 diamond reissue figure, but I repainted more of a darker color to go with this setup, whatever. Because, you know, in the first film, in the 74 film, Mechagodzilla had a more of a shiny, polished look. But in the next film, he had more of a almost battle damage, dirty look. So I just kind of painted him to reflect as such. So, and Godzilla looks great between the two of them since he did beat down both of them. And he had an original Japanese release of Mechagodzilla 1974. Billiken Jet Jaguar kit, courtesy of Burly Vang. And also courtesy of Burly Vang, from Burly Vang, a 1975 Billiken Mechagodzilla 75 kit. A little bit of awesome. And to finish things off, you got, from X Plus, you got the Godzilla 2004 from Tokyo SOS. And a standard version of Kiryu from that same movie, Godzilla Tokyo SOS. They look perfectly together. And last, here's my original Japanese release of Hedra, 30cm figure from S Plus. And once again, Burly Vang did it for me. This is a Billiken 1968 kit, but he painted to make it look like the 71. And he did an awesome job. And to see these two together is absolutely awesome. But that's pretty much it with the tour. These are all the figures I have in my collection, as well as my wife's. We're going to be getting more figures soon, you know, from X Plus in the future, whatever. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. And I appreciate y'all watching. But before I go, let me drop this jam on y'all and, you know, just... And it's kind of fitting what I'm going to play, because, you know, we all start from somewhere. And remember, my fellow collectors, it's not how many figures you have, it's the passion that you have to collect these things. As long as you're doing what you love, and as long as you have the passion for it, there's nothing wrong. You can have, it don't matter if you have 5 figures or 500 figures. As long as you have the passion, that's all that really matters. So, until then, I thank y'all for watching. I appreciate it. And I will see y'all again on the next figure and movie review. Until then, enjoy the jam while I fade out. Y'all have a good one. Take it easy.
Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team. Yeah. Bring it right back. I just think it's funny how it goes. Now I'm on the road, half a million for a show. And we started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team. Yeah, started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team. Yeah, started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team. Yeah, started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team. Yeah, boys, tell a story about the man. still. I'ma worry about me, give a fuck about you. Just as a reminder to myself. I wear every single chain, even when I'm in the house. Cause we started from the bottom, now we're here. Too much explaining. Story stay the same, I never changed it. No, we don't feel that. A fake friend, where your real friends at? We don't like to do too much explaining. Story stay the same, through the money and the fame. Cause we started from the bottom, now we're here.